In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a cross-project epic roadmap in Jira using our app Swanly. Many of us started using project roadmaps in Jira that are now available by default in both company-managed and team-managed projects. These project roadmaps are a great way to visualize and plan your project scope via epics. However, if you are like us and you run many projects in Jira, for example, for each of your products or teams, then a project roadmap isn't enough. What many of us want to do is to keep using these project roadmaps in Jira and then have one portfolio roadmap to see epics from selected projects in one place. Let me show you how you can create these cross-project epic roadmaps with the Swanly Jira plugin. In my Jira, I have these four projects that represent three different development teams and also a marketing team. Each of them uses epics and project roadmap to plan their work. Now, when it comes to seeing these project roadmaps in one place, there isn't much you can do on the standard Jira plan. And that's where Swanly comes into play. After you install the app from the Atlassian Marketplace, you can access it via the main Jira navigation menu after you click on Apps and then Swanly Roadmaps. Then, in the Issue view, you simply import projects you would like to see on the roadmap. And that's it! You created cross-project roadmap only in a few clicks. If I update the start or end date of an epic or any issue in Swanly, it will be also updated in the Jira ticket itself and on the Jira project roadmap. And of course, it does work the other way around as well. Let me just quickly explain how this works and how to change the Swanly setting to use dates from different Jira fields. Jira Project Roadmap stores its dates in custom fields called Start Date and Due Date. And Swanly then works with these dates to render the roadmap as well. This all is done via setting in Swanly where you can select what custom fields will map to start and end dates. After you install the app, Start Date and Due Date custom field will be selected by default. But you can always change that if you need to any other custom field which has a date format. And a quick note, you also don't need to synchronize with any Jira fields if that's something you are looking for. Just simply leave these fields empty and that's it. There are many more useful things that Swanly can do for you. It, for example, automatically generates these reports so you can understand how is your team progressing on a certain issue, and you can also share them. But that's for another video. Thank you for watching this one. Give us a like if you enjoyed it. Leave a comment if you have any questions, and if you didn't already, subscribe to our channel so you don't miss on the next video.